With the no more tables technique, below a certain viewpoint width, the table is collapsed and resembles a long list as opposed to table data. The nice thing about this technique is all of the data is visible, no matter what the size of the viewport is. Let's take a look with the baseball score again. In a wider viewport, everything looks good, but as the viewport shrinks, the table collapses. Every column has essentially become its own row with the table header beside it. Using a media query, I need to tell the table that below a certain width, in this case 500 pixels, I don't want it to act like a table anymore. Inside my media query, I'm going to force all table, thead, tbody, th, tr, and td elements to render as display block. Next, I need to get rid of the table header. I could set display none, but that will cause accessibility problems for people using screen readers because the browser won't tell them the column headers. Instead, I'm just going to position the content way off screen. Since the table cells are now displayed as full width block elements, I need to add some left padding and also set the position on these elements to relative. To add the row labels, I'm going to use the before pseudo selector and add td before, and inside I'll set the position to left colon 6 pixels so that I get it positioned in the right place. Now I need to add the content. I could put the labels in my CSS, but that's icky and will mean that these styles will only work for this table. Instead, I'll use content, attr, dataTh. That will then pull the values from the dataTh of each of the td elements. Here, let me show you. And there you have it. That dataTh is used as the label for each of the rows.